So to see why slicing horizontally may be necessary or useful sometimes, let's look at an example where let's find the area bounded by the curves. First we'll start with y equals ln x, so natural log of x. The second curve we'll look at, or line we'll look at, is going to be y equals 2 minus 2x. And then we'll be bounded also by the line y equals 2. So that's y equals 2 there. And so we're trying to find this area, the area bounded by those three curves. Now, there's no reason we couldn't slice this vertically. In fact, we very easily could. Just the slices here would have the line y equals 2 on the top and this curve on the bottom. And slices here would have the line on top and the log function on the bottom. And so we would end up needing to set up two integrals. And just so we can see that that can be done, let's go ahead and do it. So for the first part here, up to here, we'd be integrating from 0 to 1. On the top, we have the function 2. On the bottom, we have the function 2 minus 2x. Little tiny width. And then from 1 to wherever this is, so that's where ln x is equal to 2. Exponentiate both sides, that's where x equals e squared. We have the function 2 on top, the function ln x on the bottom, and this integral would let me find that area doing vertical slices. Looking at that, doesn't look like a lot of fun to integrate though. So let's see what would happen if we tried slicing horizontally instead. So if we tried slicing horizontally here, then a slice would go between the line and the log function everywhere over this region. And so we need to know what this x value is and that x value is given the y. So for this, we're going to need to solve these equations for x. We need to be given y, we need to find x. So doing that, let's see, y minus 2, it would equal negative 2x, moving the 2 over, dividing by negative 2, y minus 2 over negative 2, or we could multiply the top and the bottom by a negative 1 and get 2 minus y over 2. Here, we need to solve this for x. Exponentiating both sides, we get e to the y equals x. Okay, so this x value is 2 minus y over 2, and this x value is e to the y, and putting those together, then the width of my slice would be e to the y as the larger x value minus 2 minus y over 2 as the smaller y value times some tiny little dy. We're starting at a y value of 0, we're ending at a y value of 2, and there's the integral that we would need to do to find the area slicing horizontally. And this integral ends up being a lot easier to calculate. So there's an example of when we might want to slice horizontally.